Hello everyone, I'm Prashant from SIPfund.com. As part of the investor education program on fixed deposits and debt mutual funds, here is another episode where we will talk about how the interest rates of the fixed deposits have moved in last 10 years, 20 years, and how the interest rates would change in next 20 years. It's very difficult to say how the rates would change, but there is a clear historical data which will give you an idea which direction the FD rates are going to go. So consider an example where you have say 1 crore invested in a FD, and at the current FD rate, some banks are giving 6%, some are giving 7%. So let's take 7% as our example for calculation. So on a 7% rate, you would be getting 7 lakhs per year pre-tax. Post-tax, it could work out to something like 6.5 or 6 lakhs, which is comfortable 50,000 per month. Now, would this continue to be 6% or 7% in 10 years down the line? Would you get a FD rate of still 7% down the line? We know for sure we won't. Because if you look at 20 years back or 30 years back, FD rates were as high as 13% or as high as 14%. So what has been going on in FD rates? What has been going on in other countries? And how it's going to change FD rates in our country? So to understand that, let us look at the interest rates or 10-year G-Sec rate, which is also the government issued bond rates from various governments of the developed countries, and then we will come to the G-Sec rate of RBI, which is issued from the Reserve Bank of India. So now, if you look at say this graph, this is a 10-year treasury constant maturity rate. Now mind you, this is not the fixed deposit rate of US, this is similar to the G-Sec rate of Fed, which is Central Bank of America. Now if you look at 1990, the interest rates were close to 8%. It moved from 8 to 8.5, 9%, and then it basically came back to 1.5, 1% in 2020. So you see the movement, there is a variation across the period, but still the trend is basically downwards. Now the FD rates in these countries also more or less follow the central bank's yield curve, which is what we are showing here. Fall in the interest rates gets reflected in the fall in the fixed deposit rates for that country or for that currency. So this is for the US dollar. We can look at UK. Again, UK was offering a pound interest rate of 11% in 1990. Now it is less than 1%. So almost a change of 10% in last 30 years. You can look at another country, which is Japan. And Japan is very typical, because currently it is hovering around sub-zero level, the interest rates are sub-zero level. So it has seen a high of 8% in 1990, just after 1990, and it has touched 0.02% in 2020. A negative interest rate regime. Very interesting, because you could see that happening in some other countries. We can look at Germany also. Germany also had a rate decline from 8%, and this is, mind you, it was a Deutsche Mark until 2000 and was offering 8% rate. And after 2000, it was a euro currency, and therefore, again, the European Commercial Bank or European Central Bank was controlling more or less the monetary policy and therefore the interest rates. So you see in 2020, the rates have come down to 0.2 and almost going sub-zero. If you then look at the China interest rate, and China is little odd one out here, because It's been developing since it's a developing country since 2000, and it has never kind of reached a developed country status. The interest rates of Chinese currency has been going up and down. So you can see the 5% coming down to 2.5%, again going 5%. Part of the reason is it's also pegged to the US dollar, and therefore the variation of the interest rates more or less gets influenced by how the pegging has changed or not changed. So the most important thing for us, therefore, is the interest rates movements in India. So now these are 10-year government bond rates, which have moved from 13% 1990 to current rate of close to 6%, and these are G-Sec rates, it's government security rates. Now, how G-Sec rates and FD rates, there's not much difference in terms of the trend. So if the G-Sec rate currently it is around 6%, you're getting an FD of close to 6.5 or 7%. The point we have to grab here is the government yield rates across the country, if you look at it, it's been falling. So USA has gone down from 8% to 1.5, UK has gone down 11% to 1.1%, Japan has gone sub-zero, Germany has gone 0.2, and we are from 13% to at 6.5%. Now the trend is clear that the interest rates are falling. They've been falling for last 30 years. Would they fall for next 30 years? Remains to be seen. But there is a strong evidence that the interest rates would further fall. Now for a comparison, you look at the countries like US, UK, Germany, Japan. These have been developing countries in the 60s and 70s, and the 90s onward, they were more or less developed countries. And if you look at India now, we are still a developing nation, and we are already at 6.5%. So a developing country, 6.5%, we might see a small increase, maybe 7.5%, but next 30 years, one thing is clear, that these rates will only head southward, which means you could see by the time you retire or by the time you are 30 years into future, our interest rate or our FD rates could also be close to 1% or 2%. The point is, our example where somebody had 1 crore and he was enjoying a 7% interest on it, 30 years down the line, he may not get 7%, he might just get 1 lakh. So what should we do now? What should we do about it? One of the many things that you can do is save more. So somebody who was planning to have maybe 1 crore in 30 years time, he should look at maybe 2 crore or maybe 3 crores, depending on how the interest rates would fall, how fast they would fall. So if it's going to be 7% to movement from current level to say 3%, in say 30 years time, then obviously you need to double your retirement corpus or the deposits amount so that your cost of living is not affected. Mind you, I'm completely not touching on the inflation rate at the moment. We'll do that in some other episode. But in this episode, the idea was to show how the interest rates have moved from 10% level for various developed nations to almost zero or sub-zero, and this is something that is going to happen to Indian rupee also. So what we do, we save more, you be a little wise with your money, you need to devise a portfolio properly. By the time you are 60, you need to have a proper portfolio that you don't rely only on FD interest. You should have some rental income, you should have some dividends, you should have some bonds in your portfolio. Last and the most important thing is you should have an advisor who would tell you how your portfolio should be designed today. In the fixed deposit scenario, most of the time what we do is we park the money in the fixed deposit and we take the interest. And going forward, if somebody is going to rely on only the fixed deposits interest income for his livelihood is going to be very, very difficult. And therefore, let us devise a portfolio for each one of us, and let us plan in such a way that the falling interest rates impact can be mitigated or minimized. So with that, I'm closing this session, and thank you very much for joining us, and feel free to give comments or give a feedback on this on the comment section. Thank you very much.